lot is happening in Haryana. The government announced the decision to impose a 2% additional charge on registration and transfer of property. And of course, there was that controversial job reservation bill which was passed recently by the government, reserving 75% jobs, paying up to 50,000 per month for local residents. We are just asking very simple questions. What is it going to do to Gurgaon's real estate market? Because after all, a number of ITITS companies are located in this market. Anuj, Mr. Khattar clarified in a very recent interview that this reservation will not apply to technical jobs. I think the backlash was so big that he had to specify that. Having said that, I'm still wondering, are the signals beginning to look a little bit uncomfortable for MNCs, especially knowing that Noida, Jewar is right around the corner and so much cheaper per square feet?
Absolutely, Manisha. So let me begin with by saying is, Manisha, there are other states who have put in these kind of reservations in some form or the other. You know, Andhra Pradesh has it, Karnataka has it. To some extent, you know, Maharashtra tried it as well to push it through. It has its benefits and disadvantages. So clearly in the IT world, Manisha, there's going to be a fair amount of disadvantage if this was to get really pushed through. And you know, there you may see some of the corporates getting reluctant to move into Gurgaon, those who were planning to expand in Gurgaon. Conversely, what benefits with that is the affordable housing, because the guys get jobs within that market, and hence the affordable housing really starts to blossom. But if you leave the IT a little bit separate, and you're right, is that, you know, whether that is classified as technical and hence this reservation policy does not impact the IT, then it is largely on the manufacturing side. And on the manufacturing side, I would say the impact on the commercial property market is not going to be as much as it would have been if it is included in the IT, where you may see the positive benefit on the real estate is on the affordable housing uptake, given the increase in the employment of the local community.
All right. And here you have Noida government really, you know, warming laws and regulations for bringing in more manufacturing and, of course, an entire electronic city. So you're saying at least for the office market, now that the clarification has come, it is not going to change anything. Yash, what's your reading of the situation? Even the stamp duty, after saying that they're going to raise stamp duty, now I'm hearing that there could actually not be any impact on the end user. Then why announce such confusing, or why give out such confusing signals?
I think Indian politics are sometimes a mystery unto themselves. So I won't comment on the political reasons behind some of these moves. But it is welcome that the Chief Minister has clarified that the reservation is not for technical jobs and only for non-technical jobs. That said, these kind of back and forth do hurt the sentiments of the industry, especially, as you said, where Noida is working very strongly to become more pro-development and improve the amount of business that comes to that state and that city. If the ease of doing business continues to decline in Haryana, Haryana used to be the number third state in ease of doing business in 2018. It became the 16th best state in 2019. If the ease of doing business, even for non-technical jobs, because of the compliance issues, because of the kind of risk of prosecution that this local candidate bill holds, it will dampen the sentiments, as Anuj said very clearly, of the future growth. What we have to remember, Manisha, is that people come to NCR for the talent pool. But for the MNCs and the corporates which are coming to NCR, they treat NCR as one large geographical area.
Right.
And given the metro, given the roads that they're there, there is very easy mobility between a Gurgaon, Delhi and Noida for employees or for employers for that matter. If the ease of doing business is difficult in one part of NCR, it is conceivable that people would favor other parts of NCR to do that same business in, because the talent pool is similar.
All right, gentlemen, very interesting perspective. I think Haryana needs to watch out. Like you rightly said, back and forth, making announcements, then trying to explain to the whole world that this is not what we meant. But overall, if the ease of business, doing business is going down in that state, while another state is working extremely hard to make sure that it attracts business, I think it's going to be Haryana's disadvantage and probably in the future affect Gurgaon's real estate. I'm going to wrap out here. Thanks again for joining me with this. It's a wrap, and of course, we'll be back same time next week with another burning hot topic. Stay with us.